Hi, and thank you for joining me in this session. Today, we will continue our project creating a home lab using our local PC. In our previous sessions, we created two Esxi hosts on top of our local PC and a Windows domain controller with DNS functionality on it. If you want to check out those videos, there will be a card displayed up there on the right or left to the whole playlist. Today, we will install and configure vCenter Appliance version 6.7, create a data center, a cluster that will contain both Esxi hosts. So as I mentioned, you can check out the previous sessions to get up to speed, or if you just want to know how to install vCenter Appliance, you can just follow along. So without any further ado, let's get started. Here I have my vCenter Appliance version 6.7, the ISO image. As I mentioned, you can just download this from the VMware website. You will get a trial version. And for that, you just need to register a free account there and just download vCenter Virtual Appliance. So when you have your ISO image, just right-click on that, click on Mount, and after it's mounted, open the CD, go to this folder, VCSA UI Installer, Win32, and we're looking for the installer, and there it is. I'm going to run it as an administrator, just to be sure. Here we go. Now, we're going to click on Install, Deploy Appliance, yes please, next. I accept license agreement. Next, we're going to choose the embedded platform services controller, vCenter server with an embedded platform service controller, and hit next. Now, Esxi host vCenter server name. Here we will enter the IP address, and as you remember, it's 221, and we're going to leave username as root because Esxi username is root, and enter the Esxi password. Hit next. Yes, I'm just going to leave the name as it is. Here you will enter root password. Hit next, and I'm going to leave this as tiny, and hit next. I'm going to choose my NAS, and I'm going to enable thin disk mode, which as you can see, it does not pre-allocate disk space, which is what we want, and I'm going to hit next. I will take the management network just for the sake of organization, because they're both the same IP span. This is just for the sake of organization. If this is a real environment, management will be a different subnet than VM network. And fully qualified domain name, vcenter.dictory.local. Remember when we did this in the last session after we created our domain controller? So here we'll enter the IP address for this, and it's going to be 230. I think we use that IP address in the domain controller. We can double check. Let's double check. Here is my domain controller. I'm going to go to DNS, forward lookup zone, Dictory, and here is vCenter. Yeah, 230. Great. And subnet is /24. Gateway is correct. DNS server, let's double check. I think it's 101. VMD, IP config, and it is 101. So we'll amend this to 101 IP address. There we go. Hit next and finish. Now this is going to take a while, so I will pause this video and return once it's done. So fantastic. The first step has been completed. Now this happened sometimes. I've successfully completed the first step, but the installer is unable to connect to the vCenter appliance management interface. Because your computer is not pointed towards the DNS server that contains that domain name. To fix this, you can just point your computer towards that DNS server, copy this URL with the management port 5480, and paste that in your favorite web browser to continue the setup. Or do the same with the IP address and port without pointing to the DNS. I will demonstrate next. For this, we're just gonna open here. Now my local PC is not pointed towards my DNS server, which is my domain controller. That's why it cannot see this domain. So I'm just gonna type the IP address instead. 10, 10, 10, 230. Hit enter. click Advanced, and yes, please take me there. And there we go. Now we're going to click on Setup, enter your password, log in, hit Next, double check the settings here, assign static IP address. Here's my domain name for the vCenter. Here's my IP address, gateway, domain controller, SSH access. I'm going to keep it disabled for now, and I'm going to synchronize time with my Esxi servers. Next. And here it's gonna ask you to create a new Sso domain, or if you already have one, you can just join it. But I'm just gonna create one, same as this, vsphere.local. And this is gonna be used for you to sign in. So we're gonna, the username will be administrator@vsphere.local. And you're gonna enter this password. So whatever password you create here, you're gonna enter when you log into your web interface. Click Next. Here it's asking if I want to join VMware Customer Experience, and the answer is no for this. I'm going to hit Next. And just before you click Finish, make sure to double check all configuration here. Your DNS server IP address is correct, gateway is correct, hostname is correct, and hit Finish. You will not be able to pause or stop the install once you started, so that's why I said make sure that all the details are correct before you hit Finish. I'm going to hit OK. Again, this will take a little bit, so I will pause and return once this is done. Now, the setup has completed successfully, and we can log in to our vCenter appliance. Here, I'm just going to remove the management port and just go to 443 instead. Advance, proceed, launch vSphere client, HTML5. Now, this can be a problem because my computer is not pointed towards my DNS server that I created in the last session. So to rectify this, start menu and R in your keyboard, write ncpa.cpl. You will be directed to your network connections window. Click on the one you are currently connected to, right click, properties, IPv4, there we are, DNS, and that will be 10.10.10.101. Okay, okay. And refresh, advance, proceed, please. And there we go. Now, as you remember, administrator@vsphere.local is our login name. So whatever SSO domain you created during the setup is the one you're going to log in with. Fantastic. Now we are logged into our vCenter appliance. Here, right click. I'm going to create a new data center. I'm going to call this TechStory DC, short for data center. Hit enter. And within that, I will create a cluster. Before I do so, I'm going to start my SXE2 server as well. And since it started now, I will head back to my vCenter. Right click on my data center, and I'm gonna create a cluster. This cluster will be named TechStory-cluster for lack of imagination. I'm gonna enable DRS and high availability. Hit OK. There we go. Now let's add hosts. Now, SXE1 is 10.10.10.221, and SXE2 is the same but 222. I'm going to use the same credential because that's how I created it. There we go. Hit next, and there we go. We have both servers here, SXE1 and SXE2. So I'm going to highlight both and click OK, click Next, and finish. Now, as we can see, both our servers has been added into the cluster we created within the data center in vCenter appliance. So I'm going to test to move a virtual machine between the two servers. Now I have turned off my domain controller. I'm going to right click on it, click on Migrate. I'm going to change compute resources only because I'm using the same data store for both. I'm going to click on Esxi2. Click next. And yes, take the management network. Yeah, click next. And finish. Now, as we see, relocated virtual machine. Now, if we check here, we can see the host now is Esxi2. Let's move it back to Esxi1 and see if that will work. Let's go there. Next. Next. Finish. And it works. So the vMotion is working perfectly. We can migrate VMs between hosts without any problems. So now we have a full-fledged virtualization lab at home using our local PC. So to wrap up, so far we have installed two Esxi servers on top of our VMware workstation. We have installed a domain controller on Esxi1. We have installed VMware vCenter appliance on top of Esxi1. We have created a data center and cluster, and within that cluster, we have added both Esxi servers. We can now move VMs from one Esxi server to the next without any problem using our vMotion network. So that will wrap up this session. Now, I've really enjoyed this session and I hope you guys did too. In the next session, we will start actually building our internal infrastructure, which should be a lot of fun. So please share, like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next session.